Welcome in Beamer presentation, and in this video we learn about embedding a media into the frame. A media could be either a video or an audio. Apart from this, we'll also try to suppress the warnings, if any. And in the last, we'll see some overlays used in Beamer. Although I don't like to use overlays, but many of you would be fancy to use the overlays concept. So I'll explain this in brief, and for details you can refer the Beamer user guide. First of all, we'll see the embedding a media into the frame. This is the same source file which we used in the last tutorial. Here in this frame, frame number 9, I want to embed a movie as well as an audio. A media can be easily embedded with the help of Media 9 package. Some other packages are also available which we can use. For example, multimedia and movie 15. We will use Media 9. Go to preamble and add this package, Media 9. For embedding a media, we need to use include media command. This command has three arguments. One is optional and others are the mandatory. This is the working directory. And in the media folder, I have saved one audio and one video. This is in MP4 format and this is in MP3 format. Media 9 package generally supports three formats: MP4, MP3 and FLV. So video you can save either in MP4 format or in FLV format, and audio you can save in MP3 format. In optional bracket, we need to set the path of the source file. There is an option, add resource equal sign media name. I want to add this one, sample video. Just give the path of this file. This is in media folder and file name. Don't forget to write the extension name. This is MP4. One more option we need to use, and that is flash vars. For flash variables, use curly brackets. In curly bracket, we need to define the variable and its value. Variable is source equal sign and value of the source. Value will be same. This should be flash vars. This curly bracket is used for the poster text. Either we can write text or we can use image. Better to use image as a poster. And in the last curly bracket, we need to write the name of the flash player. Media 9 provides two important flash players, V player for the video and A player for the audio. Therefore, just write V player for the video. Extension is SWF. Now compile your file. Now we'll check whether our embedded video is working or not. Remember, you cannot use any PDF reader. You can use either Adobe Acrobat Reader or Foxit Reader. I would recommend to use Foxit Reader. But before this, you need to install a Flash Player. Otherwise, your embedded video will not work. Flash Player you can download from Adobe official website. Once you install the Flash Player, then you can view your embedded media with the help of Adobe Reader or Foxit Reader. In the present tutorial, I am using Foxit Reader. Just press left click of the mouse. Now our video is ready to play. Press the left click one more time for playing the video. These are the shortcuts for the media players. You can play or stop the video using a space key from the keyboard. In a similar way, we can add an audio. This is sample audio in MP3 format. For the audio, I have one image which I'll add. This one I want to add. I'll put this in the media folder. For the audio, we need to use a player. I want to put the media side by side using a columns environment. If you are interested to write a title for each media, you can use a blog. Column command should be before a begin example block. All right. Now we'll see the warnings and we'll try to suppress all the warnings we can see here. Math shift, superscript, and again math shift. These three warnings are related to the use of math in author command. If we remove, then these three warnings will be gone. This is conference title. All right, but I want to use this. Even we can suppress the warnings, but in that case we need to use this command after begin document. It's better to place all the commands related to title after begin document. Previously we used only title after begin document. I'll remove this. Go to your main text file. These two commands you can use after begin document. You don't need to use inside frame environment. Remember this. Last time we tried to use these commands inside a frame environment and we faced some problem. After begin document, immediately use these two commands. One warning always comes when we use commands related to title after begin document. PDF author has already been used. No need to worry, we can leave this. There is no effect on the layout. Next one is related to BBL. Here references are not coming, so for printing we need to compile bibliography. Citation related warning will be suppressed after compiling PDF LaTeX one more time. Next one is related to PDF version. These three images in PDF format I have saved in version 1.6. And 1.5 is the most PDF version which is allowed by LaTeX. These warnings will be gone if you save your PDF in 1.5 or in less version. Using Adobe Acrobat Pro, we can change the PDF version. Go to File, Save as Other, Optimized PDF, Acrobat 6 means 1.6 version. Now I am saving in 5.0 means 1.5 version. Similarly, we can suppress this one as well. I'll replace this. Next one is PDF inclusion, multiple PDFs with page group. We can suppress this as well. Go to preamble.tex. Just write backslash PDF suppress warning page group equal sign and 1. Compile your file. Hyperref removing translate command. This warning is related to appendix. Go to preamble, preamble tech file, and just write renew command, appendix name, appendix. Alright, now we have suppressed almost all the warnings except one. Now we'll talk about the concept of overlays in Beamer. The overlay argument in Beamer allows to write presentations with the incremental slides in the same frame. The classic example could be a list. For example, for this list, I want to print each item in different slide, but frame will remain same. We can achieve this using pointed or angled brackets. After item, just use a pair of angled brackets. Write the number dash. Each number reflects the order. Now we can see that first item, then second one is coming, third one, and last one. But frame number is the same. We can change the order. For example, you want to print this one after item 2. Then at this place, just write 4. And here, just write 3. First item, second, rather than third, fourth is coming, and then third. For the normal text, we need to use onSlide command. For example, in this frame, I want to print each paragraph in different slide. Just write onSlide, angle bracket, 1, dash. All the text should be inside curly brackets. Rather than on slide, we can use only command. No need to use dash. In this case, only one item appears on each slide at a time and at the same place. Similar effect we can get using a plus symbol in the optional bracket. So at this space, just write plus and dash. Also, we need to use pointed brackets. Overlays can also be used for the figures, tables, columns, blocks, maths, and so on. In the next, we will see for the columns. Just before column command, use angle bracket and number. This one will appear first. Second. And third, we need to use onSlide command. First column, second column, and third column. Overlays can be used for the table. Before double backslashes, just write onSlide command, number. I want to print this on second slide. Similarly, you can write for the others. We can also make the text transparent on unspecified slides with the help of set beamer covered command. So just go to particular frame. Just before begin frame, write set beamer covered transparent and invisible. Now the transparency effect can be seen for the unspecified text. This effect we can use for a particular frame, and for this we need to use this command one more time. After end frame, option is invisible. I want to use for the columns. Now coming to the table of contents. We can print the talk before each new section. So after the table of contents command, just write current section in the optional bracket. We need to highlight the particular section name. Just before begin frame, write at begin section. And put this frame inside this curly bracket. These two blank frames of the appendix we need to remove. Just after add begin section, use optional bracket, blank optional bracket. Now both blank frames are removed. So if you like the overlay, you can implement in your Beamer presentation. That's all for today's learning, and thanks for watching.